What's up, guys? Jimmy or Chaos, welcome back, and I hope you guys are getting ramped up for your holiday, whether it be Christmas or whatever you celebrate or have celebrated or going to celebrate, and I hope you get to spend it with the ones you love. I'm getting excited. Tomorrow's Christmas Eve. I want to talk to you guys. I have a specific topic I want to talk to you, but I want to say first, I'm enjoying Advanced Warfare. I'm having a blast with it, from the supply drops, the elite stuff, the custom class setups. There's all kinds of things with this game that I'm absolutely having a blast with, and you guys are tweeting me your cool supply drops. It's a lot of fun. There's a lot of hype, and there's a lot of buzz around it. We have zombies coming, so there's a ton of good stuff. But I want to talk about something that may be taken more as a negative, and it's not meant to be taken negative. I just want to get your opinion on it. And I was playing this match. As you can see, we're not doing well. I don't have a party. I'm just playing by myself. I did try to try hard it up and work on getting flags, but it didn't really work out. And then we got disconnected right after halftime, but we were getting absolutely just crushed. And what I figured out after the match is, for a big portion of this first half, I couldn't even get out of this building. It wasn't that I was trying to camp. I got hit with system hacks. I got hit with advanced system hacks that had all kinds of crazy looking Atari symbols on them. I got hit with bombing runs that were shaking the building where I couldn't get out. Then a paladin came out. Then the walker tanks came out. Then a warbird came out. And the list goes on and on. And I really couldn't even get out of the room for a point in time. And that's no excuse. You have the absolute same ability as your enemy in this game to set up your class, to be accurate, to do all the things just like they do. And I get that. But I thought about it, and I played this match. In half the match, the screen was shaking, or score streaks were going off, or things that were just in place of getting in a gunfight, if you will. And I was thinking about it, I was like, wow, it wasn't even really about getting into gunplay or gunfights with these guys. This was completely dictated by score streaks, and it brought the debate into my head. Can score streaks ruin this game? Can they make this game where it's not pleasurable and it's not enjoyable for people to play? And this match is a perfect example of that. I'm not just talking about the enemy score streaks. I'm talking about mine. I'm running a sentry turret. I'm running a UAV and a bombing run. And I know my bombing run is going to shake the crap out of the enemy and me, just like it does when they drop it on me. So if there's five people running bombing runs, and they're not that hard to get to depending on how you have your score streak class set up, the screen is going to be shaking for a good minute of the match. And then if you throw in, you sprinkle on some system hacks, some crazy system hacks that make everything crazy, then you've got that added to it. Walker tanks are going to shake the map. If a paladin comes on, it's game over because everybody's map is going to be shaking. And it got to the point where it was a little much. Now, that may be me just griping and upset because we got schwacked in this match. I'm not really. It's a game. I'm not upset at all. It was over when it was over. But it just made me wonder, are the score streaks, the system we have, set up to where you're playing advanced score streaks instead of advanced warfare? And what I mean by that is everybody loves score streaks. Everybody loves earning that bonus and getting stuff, and that's cool, but Call of Duty is based on gunplay, and it just feels like, at times, it feels like the gunplay is not even a factor in the match. Like Domination here, all I'm trying to do is run around and cap flags and avoid the bombing runs, the system hacks when they come out, or just the walker tanks, or the paladin. I mean, that's really what I'm trying to do, is just maneuver around with my exo ability. It's not, I really got to the point where I wasn't even focused about my gun at all. It was just kind of a secondary to everything else that was going on. And maybe it was just this match, maybe it was everything culminated together, and everybody on both teams was running just the exact right score streaks to make it really, really dominated by the score streaks on this map. But it's something to debate, it's something to talk about, so you guys let me know in the comment section or Twitter. Do you think the score streaks can make this game to the point where people don't want to play it or they don't enjoy it? I didn't enjoy this match. That doesn't mean I don't enjoy the game. I thoroughly enjoy the game, and I like dropping bombing runs on everybody. I think it's a lot of fun, but I also see it from the other end, and it's just something I wanted to discuss with you guys, not trying to be in a negative light or anything like that. I just want to see what your opinion is. Do you think maybe there should be some more custom tailoring to these score streaks and how they're set up? And how the attachments work, maybe some tweaks need to happen. I don't know. You guys let me know what you think. Like I said, I hope you have a great Christmas. I'll have videos up. I'll have a video up on Christmas, I'm sure. Maybe a vlog or something. But I hope you are enjoying your time with your family. Have a great day.